Well, I welcome here with me John O'Donnell. You are Vice President Business Development of the US-based company Glasspoint. And you're here with us on the conference, Solar Heating and Cooling, in Chile. Sorry for that. Your company started 2009. It's fairly new. You have already 300 employees, so it's fast growth. And you are concentrating on oil refining companies, and you sell them ship. I think this is a rather conservative sector, and I wonder how you succeed to convince them to use such a modern technology like solar.
Well, thank you, and we're delighted to be here. We are focused exclusively on solar energy for industrial processes, and our belief was, first of all, that economies of scale apply in this industry as in others. So development costs and other things can be very high for small projects. Glasspoint started with a fundamentally new technology. As you know, we put the collectors inside agricultural greenhouses. The greenhouse industry builds thousands of hectares a year around the world. They have very low cost. It allowed us to build a new kind of collector that weighs 10% as much as the existing parabolic troughs. That brought the cost of energy below the cost of fossil fuels if we're building large projects. When we started, we said, we can't do everything. We're going to focus in areas where we can identify large projects where the energy price is of high value to the customer.
So you are dealing in a sense there is no subsidy involved, it's pure economics, it makes sense, and there are no regulations.
So that is market by market. But today, as you know, there's a 1,000 megawatt project contracted and a 2,000 megawatt project announced in Oman. Tomorrow here at the conference, I'm mentioning that the first 300 megawatts of the first project are now online. Those projects are there because they're lower cost than the cost of natural gas, with no carbon cost and no subsidies. So there are other places in the world where carbon costs are an important part of the value of solar thermal energy. And of course, everywhere in the world, the solar industry is the only portion of the world energy industry that offers fixed prices. Everywhere else, you know, the volatility of fossil fuel energy and the risks about future carbon costs are part of how industry thinks about things. But that fixed cost of energy is an important part for industries where energy is an important part of the product. Now, in what we do today, the cost of steam is two-thirds of the cost of producing the product. So it was important to the customer. Many industrial customers, the cost of energy is maybe only 10% of the cost of the final product. So in the session earlier, there was discussion about what industry we need industry to pay attention. It's very natural in the industries that we're in today for people to seek the lowest cost of energy. And here in Chile, there's rising awareness about energy costs because Chile has seen high volatility in the cost of available energy. So there are other industries as well, mining and others, that are paying careful attention now in the solar industry.
You mentioned the discussion we just had. You know, it was a panel on looking into what makes solar industrial heat pick up worldwide. And one subject which always comes up is ESCO, you mean. That means you sell heat instead of hardware. But this is not your business model. Do you agree on that for other sectors it could be a good business model?
It's not quite correct that it's not our business model. So we offer both. So our California project, the Belridge project, is on an ESCO model, and so that Glasspoint has collaborated with other developers, and we are willing to work both ways, because if you're a mining company, your capital is going to go into mines, and that's what you know deeply. If you're an oil company, you know about putting capital there. There is a sophisticated worldwide investor base that invests in solar projects, which are low risk, lower return, long payback infrastructure projects. It's very sensible to bring solar industry capital to build ESCO projects for these other industries. And so economically it's more sensible. It is also operationally more sensible. Some of the conversations here, adopting a new technology is much more comfortable if the supplier is taking all the technical risk.
Yeah. Absolutely. So let's go back to Mira. I think this is your first plant, which is really in sort of in under construction. And the intelligent thing is that you can always put different blocks on steam already, 25 megawatt, I think. So you will announce tomorrow the next step, which is 300 megawatt. Is this still in the schedule that you originally planned? Because we know that all large size systems usually delayed.
Yeah. So the schedule, we began operation in Oman with a pilot in 2012. We were awarded Marah in 2015. We began first operations in 2017, and we have been coming online on time, on budget, and on spec. One of the things I'll speak about tomorrow is that we've passed our performance tests for the first phase, and we're in performance testing now for the second. We organized the project in phases because as you build a large project, you learn, and then you can apply those lessons learned in kind of in the next phase. So we are on track, and we're very proud of the fact that our projects have been on time, have met their specs, and we are now at more than 6 million worker hours with zero injuries. We have been 100% safe since the company began. And that's partly a testament to solar energy. It's also very specifically a testament to our focus on design for safety as well as execution. Reducing the material weight 90% means workers have to handle much less. So in industrial environments, so Marah is 800 kilometers away from town. Every person at Marah has to live in a camp. Marah experiences ambient temperatures above 48. Marah has dozens of heavy dust storms a year. It is a challenging environment, and the fact that we've proven that solar can work reliably there means anywhere on Earth that's true.
This is an excellent last word. So I wish you very good luck, and I think that we'll hear a lot more from Glass Point in the future.
Thank you so much. It's a pleasure.